What up, gamers? So, today I wanted to do something different. I wanted to draw a monster that I would like to see, or that I think would be cool to have in VHS. Disclaimer, these are not suggestions. You know what I mean. Suggestions for the devs, okay? I love what they do with the game. I love the art, I love every design they have, so don't take this as, ugh, I can do better. It's not that, I just want to do some fan art, I guess. So, yeah, these are just my designs that I think would be pretty cool to have, so that's about it. Let's start. Let's have some fun. So, I wanted to create a scarecrow monster. I really like scarecrows. I think they're pretty cool, they're pretty scary, and I think they would fit VHS pretty well. I think they would make great monsters, well, monster characters, because of their unique body types and the way they move, the way you can make them sound. I think the best representation for that would be Fiddlesticks from League of Legends. I love Fiddlesticks, it's my favorite character in League, actually. So, yeah. It's kind of what I took as reference, but not really. I wanted it to be more tall and slender than compared to other monsters in the game that are already in. With long arms, big hands, and long legs. Yeah. In classic scarecrow fashion, I gave him a cloth that goes over his head, ending in kind of like a hood, gloves and boots. I wanted to stay kind of true to the design philosophy of VHS, meaning it can't look too crazy since these monsters are inspired by 1980s, 1990s movies. And back then, CGI wasn't really a big thing, so it had to be made practical. And given that, I had a choice between a more costume-like design that like a human could wear, or a more puppet-like design. And I went with the more puppet-like design. To break up the silhouette a bit, I made his left arm out of wires, inspired by some designs from the Five Nights at Freddy's series, like Ennard, Morton Freddy, whatever. Really like those designs. I think it fits pretty well. I put barbed wire all over his body and coming out from under his cloth. His weapon, of course, is a scythe. I imagined him having a long launch attack, but being a bit slower than other killers because of his size. I'm going back on this later, so I don't think this is going to be a very easy to kill monster. Thank you. glowing eyes make him a bit more menacing. And I like it. I think it turned out fine, the shading and stuff. Now, let's go over his abilities, shall we? First off, Deadly Presence. Deadly Presence, I imagine, has a 45 second cooldown. And it's kinda the location finding ability of this monster to find teens and stuff. So, when activated, the Scarecrow makes its presence known, revealing him for 5 seconds in a radius of 50 meters. Every teen in that radius who saw the Scarecrow is revealed for 7 seconds and begins to scream and breathe very loud for 12 seconds. Basically, you show yourself, everyone who saw you show yourself, now you can see them. It's kinda like high risk, high reward ability. So you can't just use it whenever, you actually have to think about when to use it. Because they can see you now. Next up is Barbed Wire Veins. 10 second cooldown. On activation, the Scarecrow can lay barbed wire on the ground 3 separate times. These stay either until destroyed or the Scarecrow places more. When a teen walks through these barbed trip wires, yeah, see what I did there? They stumble, slowing them down, and they begin to scream. If a teen walks through 2 trip wires in a short period of time, they take damage and go into the hurt state. I imagine the Scarecrow to play more like a tactical killer. Setting up your trip wires and then baiting the teens to walk through them so you can get easy hits off of them. And the last ability, Terror Incarnate, 15 second cooldown. If a teen hasn't seen the Scarecrow for some time, they get nervous and their nervousity meter fills up. So the Scarecrow brings in a new mechanic, a meter that fills up your nervousity, okay? You don't see the Scarecrow, the killer, you get nervous. So, on activation, the Scarecrow pours all of his terror out onto the teens. Teens that have a nervousity meter of 70 and higher get jump scared and aren't able to use their weapons for 15 seconds. Teens that have a meter of 50 until 70 aren't able to use their weapon for 13 seconds, and teens that have 0 to 39% can't use their weapons for 10 seconds. Yeah, I think that's pretty cool. I think that's a pretty cool mechanic. So it actually like makes teens engage more with the monster in a way. So there's actually like not really a reward, but I mean, yeah, you know what I mean. It actually kind of rewards you not just running away from the monster all the time. And that's actually about it. As a map, I imagined like a field area with multiple like buildings, farm, like a farm area or something. So, yeah, that's it. See ya. Hope you liked it. Tell me what you think of it. Let's have a discussion. Tell me some of your ideas. Yeah, that's it. Bye-bye.